The Injured Senior Podcast is here to help. Like it or not, the senior and elderly population is vulnerable to negligence committed by medical professionals, nursing homes, assisted living facilities, pharmaceutical and medical device companies, insurance companies, and everyday individuals and businesses. Your host, Steve Heisler, creator of the National Injured Senior Law Center, has been advocating for seniors' rights for over 30 years and is bringing you answers to your questions. This is the Injured Senior Podcast.
Hello to all in the injured senior community. This is Stephen Heisler, CEO and founder of the National Injured Senior Law Center, and you are tuned in to the latest edition of the Injured Senior Podcast. The Injured Senior Podcast is a show dedicated to discussing medical and legal issues of vital importance to the injured senior and elderly population and their families, loved ones, and caregivers. We are sponsored by the National Injured Senior Law Center, the legal advocates for seniors and the elderly who are injured by the negligence of others. If you believe you've been harmed by a medical professional, nursing home, or by a medical device, go to www.injuredseniorhotline.com or call 877-228-4878. So, I know this is the Injured Senior Podcast, and we like to talk about medical and legal topics that are of interest to you listeners, but we also like to bring on to the show experts in the area of aging. We've had some super guests in the past episodes who have shared about successful aging, and I think you're going to love who we have on today. So, injured senior community, we have with us Dorian Mincer, whose company is Revolutionize Your Retirement. She holds a master's degree in social work, has her PhD. She's got 50 years of clinical experience. Dory is a speaker on the topics of retirement transition, money, relationships, and is an executive coach, therapist, consultant, and writer. She hosts a popular monthly Revolutionize Your Retirement Interview with Expert series on the fourth Tuesday of each month, open to professionals and the public, meaning listeners of this show. She is also the co-author of the award-winning book, The Couple's Retirement Puzzle, The 10 Must-Have Conversations for Creating an Amazing New Life Together, and has contributed to a number of other books. Good day, Dory, as I've been instructed to call you. How are you doing today?
I'm fine, and I'm delighted to be with you for this program.
We are so delighted to have you, Dory. And where are you? You're based out of what state?
Massachusetts, the Boston area.
That's what I thought. Your Red Sox beat my Orioles yesterday.
Yeah,
so we're going to have to get some revenge on them on Saturday. But I hope things are well in Massachusetts, and hopefully you're not snowed out up there in April. I am really glad to have you on the show today, Dory. I turned 60 in September, and my wife is 50. I want to learn how to revolutionize my retirement, you know, when that day arises. So I think you're the right guest to appear on this show today. So when you say retirement, you know, the notion is that either you're at or you're near retirement, and that your lifespan is probably not that long from when you retire. Is that usually the case? Is that usually how people perceive retirement?
You know, that was more the notion of retirement in the 20th century, when we didn't live as long as we are now. So the notion about retirement really has been changing. We are living longer. This is what's called the longevity revolution. And so at the typical retirement age, which is 62 or 65, people may have another 20, 30, 40 years to live. So I like to think about retirement as a transition. And it's really no longer thought so much as a destination, but it's a transition. And it's helpful to think about what are you retiring to? You may want to keep working. You may want to work in a different way. You may want to not work at all. You may want to just have a life of leisure. There's really no right way. But I think what has been changing is it's not a retirement from life. It's a retirement from whatever the work was that you were doing. And there's a lot of life left, so that there's an opportunity for, you know, new opportunities and new potential. The other part that I always like to mention is, you know, it really is a transition or a journey. And if you think about it, all transitions have an end. There's usually a middle, maybe a period of uncertainty, maybe not, and then a new beginning. And I think it's similar in retirement. And, you know, you may really be burnt out and tired and want to take time off, but then give yourself permission to think about, how do I want to live this next part of my life? What's next?
Yeah, I think that's a really good way of looking at things. So why is it, though, that people usually go through a midlife crisis or, you know, get really depressed when they have to retire?
Well, I'm not so sure that happens so much anymore. I mean, I'm not a believer that everybody has to have a midlife crisis. Instead, I like to think about it is that there are these midlife shifts that happen with us. You know, if you think about it, often our definition of success begins to change. You know, we reach a point in our life where it's like, who am I? You know, who do I want to be? Who are you if we're in a relationship? Who are we? It doesn't have to be a depressing time, but I think the old way of thinking about retirement, there were a lot of D words. It was like detachment, depression, death. I think now when people are realizing both that we're living longer, but also, you know, that retirement isn't necessarily an end point, not a destination. It's like potential of a new beginning. People are thinking about our words like revolutionize or rewiring or reinventing. I mean, it really is a time of possibility. So I hope your listeners may be able to cast off this notion that it's all downhill. I mean, it really used to be thought that, you know, we learn, then we work, and we reach, you know, the top. And, you know, and then you just kind of hold on and kind of wait to die. Now, if you think about longevity as bonus years, now you've got, you know, as I mentioned before, 20, 30, maybe 40 more years with a lot of peaks and valleys. These are potentially exciting times. You know, we can't control all of it, and we may be dealing with health issues, but it really is a time to grow and learn and evolve and explore.
Right. Yeah, I mean, I'm 60 years old, as I said earlier, and, you know, I feel like I'm 40, and I have a lot of energy, and I would, if I decided to hang up the spikes, so to speak, as far as my law career, there's so many other things that I'm interested in that, yeah, to me, a second career or different projects, that excites me, and that's something that I'd want to do. Is that something that you're now seeing that people are getting involved in?
Absolutely. And I think, it's terrific that you're at the age that you are, thinking about what are the other interests that you have? What are other parts of your identity? You know, if work is your total identity, or I also say the same thing with people that are full-time parents, if parenting is your only identity, then, you know, when the kids have moved out or when you've retired, people can feel like, who am I without work? It's so helpful if you are younger to think ahead. What are things I'm interested in? What are things maybe I had to put on the back burner, you know, during all these other parts of life? What are things that people I admire are doing? I really encourage people, if you're thinking about it ahead of time, to think about and begin to develop some of those interests. And if you're already during the, you know, kind of traditional retirement age or older, it's really not too late to think about what more things might you want to learn, or what other things might you want to do. It really can be an exciting time if you open yourself up to this idea of, new beginnings and possibilities, but being realistic that, you know, there may be some limitations as we age, and there may not be. I mean, I'm 75 and still, you know, working and love it. And I've changed a little of how I work. My work is sort of like a portfolio career, unlike, I think, law, like, you know, is more, you know, it's a legal practice. But I do, as you said in the introduction, I do a little therapy. I do some coaching. I do this program that I mentioned on the fourth Tuesday at noon Eastern time. I do writing. I do speaking. And so it keeps me engaged, but I can kind of let go of some parts and do a little less if I want to open up time for other parts, or I can let go and, you know, and have time to play too, because I'm a believer that, you know, play is and enjoying oneself and downtime is really important too.
Now, when you're playing, Dory, you're definitely playing within the legal limits, right? You're not, I mean, I don't want to get any calls from Massachusetts that, you know, you got your one phone call, so I'm just
keep
messing
that in
with
mind,
you.
Yes.
All kidding aside, Dory, I've been very lucky in that I have not suffered any type of major health crisis or either minor health crisis in my lifetime. I hope the same has happened with you. But I know we have a lot of listeners who have had major health issues that might have forced them to retire, or that is at this present time is captivating their lives. Does the same revolutionize your retirement or the second part of your life? Does that apply to them as well?
Absolutely. You know, I like to think about sort of the puzzle part of life, which is part of the book I co-wrote, that you know, the puzzle of our life has many components in it. Finances, health and wellness, spirituality, work, where we live, relationship and obligations to family. And I often like to say that I think finances and health and wellness are the two biggest pieces of the puzzle, and they impact everything else. And there's a reality that we have to deal with, whatever our reality is. You know, I guess it's a redundance to sort of say the reality of the reality, but it's there. Research right. says that by the time we're 65, it's 30% genetics and 70% things we can control, which includes exercising our body and brain. It includes spirit, you know, it includes nutrition. It includes meaningful relationships. And of course, if people are dealing with health issues, some of this may be harder to negotiate. But what I have found is if you have some positive attitudes about yourself and your life, those positive attitudes can really make a difference on how you negotiate the next stage. There's no question the ending and not having control over the timing of retirement is very hard. You know, some people, it's because of health. Other people, it's maybe because of mergers and downsizing. I don't think any of us like the control taken away from us. But I think what's important, what I always like to say to people is connection, engagement, and purpose and meaning is really important for us. So with or without good health, it's still important to think about how might you, whatever the limitations are that you have, how might you build some aspects of connection, engagement, and purpose and meaning into your life? But there's no question, the longer we live, you know, there is a likelihood that, you know, if you're in a relationship, one or another will be a caregiver or care receiver. Or if you're not in a relationship, that you may be a caregiver or care receiver. And we, you know, that's part of the reality of getting older. But I think it is important to think about how do we be what I like to think about is optimistically realistic, where we're able to be realistic about what our health situation is, but to try to the best of our ability to think about what are still the positive things that we can do. And there's actually been a study out of Yale by Dr. Becca Levy that says positive attitudes about aging can actually add about 7.5 years to your life. And, you know, that is, even if people have multiple chronic illnesses or even terminal illnesses, attitude, mindset really is important. But no question that there's some grieving that's understandable and needs to be dealt with if, in fact, the choice of retiring or not is taken away from you, either because of, you know, the industry you're in or your health. But to then try to think about what are the things you can do. And, it, you know, there may be other ways of reinventing yourself.
So if any of our listeners want to reach out to you, maybe listen to, I think, the series that you were talking about, can you just give some contact information and just a quick rundown about your show?
Be happy to, Steve. Thank you. Well, my website is revolutionizeretirement.com. And if you go to my website, you'll see you'll learn about me. You'll learn about some of the services I provide. I provide, you know, coaching and therapy and, you know, pretty much virtually these days. And this fourth Tuesday program that Steve mentioned, it's the fourth Tuesday of each month at 12 noon Eastern time. I interview experts, and it's free and open to professionals and the public. Sign up always starts the week before at www.revolutionizeretirement.com. And if you sign up and you end up that you're not able to be there live, everybody who signs up gets a recording link after the call. And it's been my way of just bringing experts to people that, you know, either I've met or I've heard of, people who've written books or done really interesting things. So I encourage all of your listeners to be part of it. My email is dorian@dorianmincer.com. And I'm a retirement transition coach. And there are a number of people around the country, the world. There's an organization called Retirement Coaches Association, another organization called the Life Planning Network. There's some people, you know, who live maybe where your listeners live. But if not, most coaches do tend to work virtually. So I would encourage people that it's good to think ahead if you still are in the pre-retirement kind of stage of life, so that you can think about what you're retiring to and, you know, what's important to you. But I also encourage people, you know, even if you have retired, you know, if, you know, you may have been in the honeymoon of retirement and really enjoying yourself, and it's not unusual a few years down the road sometimes. I get a call from people or an email, and people say, something's missing from my life. I don't know what it is. And so, you know, I'm a believer that it's helpful to, you know you're not alone and ask for help if you need it. And I encourage you, it's a really exciting time of life. If you can open yourself and think about it as a time to learn, grow, evolve, and keep learning and growing, evolving.
Thanks for that, Dory. And thank you also for your service to the senior and elderly population. You definitely are someone that can give some real value to our listeners. So I just thank you for that. And I'm looking forward to chatting with you soon. So take care. And we will, like I said, we'll be talking again shortly.
Great. Look forward to it.
Injured senior and aging population community. Thanks for listening to today's episode. I want to again thank Dr. Dorian Mincer for appearing on the show today. She did a wonderful job, gave so many great tips and nuggets on how to power charge your life when you get into the senior and elderly category. If you love the Injured Senior podcast, we'd love for you to subscribe, rate, and give a review on your favorite podcast platform. If you want to share your story about any issue of medical negligence or any type of negligence, or you want to talk about how you've revolutionized your retirement, feel free to email me at steve@injuredseniorhotline.com, and we might have you on the show. Until next time, looking forward to next week's show. Stay safe, be well, and I'll talk to you soon. Goodbye, everybody.
Thanks for listening to the Injured Senior Podcast. If you enjoyed the podcast, please rate, subscribe, review, and share on Apple, Google, or wherever you get your podcasts. Connect with us at InjuredSeniorPodcast.com and sign up for our newsletter. To find out more or to get help at any time, visit InjuredSeniorPodcast.com or call 855-622-6530. That's 855-622-6530.